Lost in the Masquerade. I love that song, George Benson, Breezin'. And good evening, hello, George Mason. What we want to talk about tonight is fame overrated? Being famous, a lot of people, this is what they strive for, this is their dream. They want the fame, they want everything that comes along with it, the money. Some people don't understand that there's a price to pay. Are they willing to pay that price? What the price is, we don't know. What is that? Mark and James. Mark 8:36. What does it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? And that's heavy there, because a lot of people do. They don't care. They'll do anything to make it at all costs, any cost. So it's just to each his own, as they say. You know, but there's levels to fame. You have the Michael Jordan fame. You have people that are legitimately famous for having certain degrees of talent. Your Madonna's, your Cher, Whitney, Michael Jackson, of course, Prince. These were legitimate superstars. And then you have your reality stars. They call them, I don't even know, the word star, I don't know if that really fits. These are just people just, you know, for the most part, just put into a situation and then doing things. Years ago, they had this K+8. The lady, she had 8 babies, and they thrown her into the limelight. They put her out there, made her so-called star. She was famous for having babies. The Octomom, this bitch was fucking nuts. She was fucking crazy. She looked like Angela Jolie, looked like she sucked a good dick, but she was out of her fucking mind. You know, should have took the babies away from her. The baby should have been taken to a shelter, foster care. She didn't look stable at all. The bitch looked like she was fucking on serious medication, you know. But they gave her a show, and it made her, she had some notoriety and some fame. Some degree of fame. And that's the other thing. It's just, you know, and that we will just worship. Yeah, that's the thing, right? We're not supposed to be idol worshipers. You know, right? That's what we were taught. But we do it. You know, we go for whoever is on top, whoever is that, you know, personality, that Oprah. Like I said before, Michael Jordan, this guy can't walk out in the street like a normal human being, you know. And I like what Jay-Z had said about fame.
And I ain't even wanted to be famous. This is brainless to unnecessarily go through these changes. And I don't even know how I came to this. Set that famous. The worst drug known to man is strong bad. Heroin, where you could look in the mirror like, there I am, and still not see what you become. I know I'm guilty of it too, but not like them. You lost one.
Let go to get one.
That shit is deep. Famous is the most known drug known to man, fame. And that says it all right there. And we look at it, you know, like making it. You know, I talked about it yesterday, making it, how I didn't have the desire to make it. That's for one reason, you know, of the price you have to pay. and things that you have to act. I'm never good at playing a game, you know, kissing ass and then schmoozing and then, you know, these people like you call them, they don't return your calls. It's just the whole way the whole system is set up. But then when you make it, you have some degree of notoriety. You know, what's up, right? For that moment, then everybody is on you, you know. It's not about who you are, it's what they can get from you and who they think you are. It's like walking out in the street or whatever. You might do a TV show or have a good show, whatever. Then people, you know, now they want to, you know, suddenly yesterday you were nobody. Now, you know, and that's why a lot of these rappers, I see they get bitter. Like, you know, yesterday I couldn't, you know, you wouldn't even say hello or what's up. But now you all over me because, you know, so it's like that. And it's like we all got to keep things in perspective if possible. But, you know, with the social media, the way it is and how people are, you know, looking at things, perceiving perception, I don't think that it'll ever be where people will just judge us just on face value for who you are. You know, you meet a person, you say, hey, man, what's up? And then everything is good on that level. But we all strive, we're just trying to get to a level. You know, me personally, do I want to be famous? I would like to eat and pay bills. It's hard being funny when you're broke, you know? And I'll tell you, that's where it's at with me. You know, I do stand up in the whole comedy. This COVID shut everything down, you know, getting to work, it's difficult, you know, but that's where my whole head is at, paying bills and eating. You got friends and family. You want to keep them close to you during this time, this situation that's going on. And you always say thanks and give you thanks to the Almighty, the Most High, Jehovah God. I acknowledge him every day, say my prayers, I'm on my knees, because it's important during these times. So Book of Revelations say we're in the last days. I believe that. But I want to do a little brief bit, a little taste of something, just to give you an example of material. I have extensive amount of materials, and but this is one of my favorites. I like this one because it involves, you know, New York City. Everything now is fast, right? New York is attitudes. Everybody in New York City has an attitude and they're in a hurry. Even the homeless people, even homeless. And I was in 42nd Street, going down the street, and this guy, man, you know, homeless cat, he tried to rush. I grabbed him, he tried to rush by me. I said, yo, man, where the hell are you going? What are you in a hurry for? Where are you going? Home? Aren't you home already? He got an attitude. He didn't like that shit. He's like, yo, yeah, you know what? He said, sir, old school, you're right. I am home. By the way, get the fuck out of my house. I had to deal with that, you know. So, but, and we're in a whole new age now, automation, right? It's at another level. Internet, right? It's taking things now. Everything is fast. I got into a little beef not too long ago. Got a little situation. I had to call 911 and they put me on hold. It was deep. It was like, thank you for calling New York City Emergency Help Hotline 911. All our operators are busy now. Please hold. If you're being shot at, press 1. If you're being attacked with a knife, press 2. And if you're black in a white neighborhood, or white in a black neighborhood, hang up now and call an Uber. To add some out of that hood. But yeah, those bits there, just a little something, something. And we're working it out. And what I want to do, accomplish with this, hopefully, as I said, my first foray into this tape that I made, get the young generation, you know, bring them into the fray, you know, to show them that there's, you know, we got their back, that things are, well, it's bad for everybody now. I can't front it off. It's not at all to say it's not when it is, but at least that they have a friend, someone they can talk to, someone they can come to, that kind of thing. And what we can do is do what we do. I just want to thank you again for tuning in. I say God bless you, and have a good night, and peace be unto you. Yes, yes, yes.